Snapshot 25W09A brought us datapack version 69. And that brought us new abilities for the SNBT format and changes to entity data. My name is Sliced Lime and this is a showcase of the changes. Let's start with commands and SNBT. SNBT is the format used in commands and some other places to specify NBT data, a string-based version of NBT. That format gets a big upgrade in this version. To begin with, the format now supports heterogeneous lists anywhere, that is, lists that contain entries of different types. This means that using the data command to change a line on a sign now works, for instance, even if the format of all the lines don't match up, some being strings and some being full text components. When specifying lists or compounds, you are now allowed to specify one trailing comma. Arrays still require a unified type, but values of smaller types are now also allowed. For instance, it is now valid to list a byte as part of an int array. If the given values for an array do not have type suffixes, they will be read as the same type as the array. Those type suffixes have also been extended. Integer types can now also include an S or a U to signify that the value should be read as signed or unsigned. This only affects the parsing range for those values, so the value is always converted to a signed value after being read. Integer numbers can now be specified in hexadecimal formats by prefixing them with OX, and in binary representation by prefixing them with OB. Starting a number with just 0 is no longer allowed unless the value is exactly 0. When numbers are specified without a suffix, that now has a new default interpretation. If the value is decimal, it is treated as signed. If it is binary or hexadecimal, it is treated as unsigned. Another new function is the ability to use underscores for readability in numbers. Underscores are allowed anywhere in a number except at the very beginning or end, and are simply ignored when the number is parsed. Floating point number formats have been extended as well, where the whole or fraction parts of a float can now be omitted, so both 1 point and 0.1 are valid floats. Float numbers now also support exponential notation, with a lower or uppercase e both being valid to denote the exponent. And note that floating point representations of not a number and infinity are not supported. Unquoted strings no longer support starting with zero, periods, or plus or minus signs to distinguish them from numbers. For quoted strings, more escapes are now available, with standard escapes like backslash n and backslash t now working, but also including Unicode escapes in both numeric and written out forms. With that, let's move on to data changes. Many fields have been fixed to properly get reverted to their default values when removed with the data command. Overall, many fields in different entity types and block entity types now get the same default value when set with a command as when placed into the world by a player. Of particular note, the default value of the duration field of area effect clouds has been changed to -1, which means area effect clouds summoned without a specific duration no longer vanish instantly. For a cloud with -1 as duration, they will instead never expire. And that's all for datapack version 69. Thank you for watching. My name is Sliced Lime, and I'll see you next time. Nice!